It's Adelaide, the early 80s. A hyperactive Wesley Carr was causing havoc, and there was only one way to calm him down.
I used to put Thriller on the stereo and dance around, and it'd be like 6 or 7 hours and just come out sweating and panting, and Mum and Dad would just be just shaking their heads going, this kid's insane.
Naturally drawn to music, Wes was in a world of his own.
School, I never really fit in at all. Like, on the scale of 1 to 10, it would have been probably -1.
People always told me, be careful what you do, but don't go around breaking young girls' hearts.
Always marching to his own beat, 10-year-old Wes thought he'd enter a Michael Jackson lookalike contest.
And I put on a white vest thing. And a white glove, and thought, oh, yeah, that'll do.
Yeah, blondest, whitest, most ridiculous thing ever.
I got up and sung in front of like 2,000 people. It wasn't the best fashion. Johnny Young was there, and I thought that was pretty special at the time. I grew up on the Johnny Young TV, and I was in love with Tina Arena.
Give him a big round of applause.
And got into the Adelaide Young Talent Team, and then I started doing appearances all around town. Being in local pantomime. Every school holidays I'd be working as a singer.
Splish splash, I was taking a bath.
Despite the on-stage smiles, at home, Wes's parents were going through a bitter separation, and Wes was heartbroken.
I'll never forget the day when Dad packed up his trailer and drove off and sort of was like, didn't really know when he was going to see us again, kind of thing. Started writing songs, a result of my parents breaking up.
Crying, everlasting love.
When I got home, I just sort of locked myself in my bedroom, and then at school I was like the biggest extrovert.
After several run-ins with teachers, at age 15, Wes was expelled and sent to live with his dad in Sydney. After finishing year 10 at his new school, Wes would play his very first pub gig.
All the memories are not to fade.
It would be 6 long years sitting on that bar stool, hoping for some kind of breakthrough. Back in 2004, watching 22-year-old Wes was Ben Gillies from Silverchair. The two hit it off and formed a band called Tambourlaine. They self-funded tours and an album. But with little recognition, the band ran out of money. It was another heartfelt blow.
After Tambourlaine, I didn't really know where I was going with music. I thought I might pack it in, might give it up. It didn't work in the end, and you put your heart and soul into something and sometimes it doesn't come off, but you just got to move on.
And move on he did.
New Year's Eve, I had a little silent thought to myself and I thought, okay, this has got to be it. This has got to be the year that I actually do something for myself and take a stand for myself. I'll never forget walking in and it was just this silence and I'm thinking, don't screw it up now.
All along the watchtower. I was born in a crossfire.
I'm such a fan. You could make a record tonight and I would buy it.
I'm going to remember this for the rest of my life. It's inspired me to believe in myself a little bit more.
If I were a carpenter,
I just feel like I need to go and kiss everybody who's voted. I don't know how to thank them enough. I feel like finally I've got something right.
So for this hard-working and committed young musician, his story is a testament to belief, heart, and an unfailing spirit.
I'll give you my holiness. Give me your tomorrow.